The King County real estate market has been pretty tough to navigate as a buyer in the past few years. This year has been especially tough. I often hear from buyers who can't find that perfect house out on the market that they're going to buy land and build a house instead. If you've considered this, then this is the perfect video for you. This is Karen Jackson with John L. Scott Real Estate. Thank you so much for watching. I'm going to go over the process of how to build a home. First, you need land. Purchasing land is quite different than purchasing a home. You will want to make sure you work with a realtor who knows the process of buying land. You need to be sure that the lot you're purchasing is buildable in the county's eyes. When you shop for land, here are some things that you need to watch out for. First off, what is the utility situation? Some land has utilities on the property, some has it in the street, and some you have to put your own septic and well on it. In addition, there are studies that may need to be done per the county's requirements. There are critical area studies and wetland studies, site evaluations, and geo studies if there's a slope. Next, how are you going to purchase the land? Do you need a loan? If so, you will need to talk to a lender to get a pre-approval. There are some lenders that specialize in land. If you're not planning to build right away, you might be able to get a lot loan. They have a little bit stricter requirements. There are very few lenders that do lot loans, but they are out there. If you're planning to build right away, you can get a construction loan. In order to get a construction loan, you need to have your house plan, your builder, and you may need some upfront money for the design and studies before your loan closes. You can pay yourself back usually with the construction loan, but typically construction loans require permits in hand in order to close the loan. In order for the permit to be approved, the studies need to be done, and permits can take up to a year in King and Pierce County, depending on what time of year it is. You need to find a house plan and a builder. Are you going to do a custom build or a prefab home or hire a general contractor and sub out all the different jobs? The more custom you go, the more money it costs. There are some builders that do it all, and there's some builders that do a package, but then you are responsible for some of the jobs like dirt work and concrete, some even foundations, painting. So you'll need to build costs in for that. You need to be sure to have a budget and then add 10% because most people go over budget in the construction process. So now you have found your land, you picked your builder and your floor plan, and you got your permits. Now it's time to build. Now the fun starts. Once you get your permits, you can start the building process. If it is a custom build, you will need to start shopping for design items. If it is a builder that provides a package, you need to test your patience. And if you're owner builder or being a general contractor, then you have your work cut out for you and you need to get those bids going. One tip I have is to take pictures along the way. These are good for the memory book, but they also come in handy if you have a septic system or special wiring in the house, or if you plan to add any features later down the road. You might need to know where that plumbing is or wiring is. And it is helpful to have pictures. You can always delete them if you took too many. If you would like to learn more about the costs involved in building a home, please check out my video on is it cheaper to buy land and build a house or buy a house? Thank you so much for watching, and I will see you next time.